Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And we're going to talk about entertainment and activism.
Yay.
And yeah, I know, right? It's real exciting. It is a hot topic right now because it seems more and more that the entertainment industry, various parts of it, publishing, video games, comics, all of it, animation, it all seems to be used for activism now. And, you know, we're seeing some more examples of that, and especially in the last couple months, obviously, because of stuff going on in the country right now. But it does seem like this was sort of by design. This does seem like it was a talking point, even going back to last year, that at some of the social media summits, they were talking about how to use entertainment platforms for activism.
Great. I can't wait to see the ones against trafficking.
Yeah, you might be waiting a while.
I'm just saying.
Yes. So we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the article that actually kind of kicked it off. And I got to give a shout out to Martin, who sent an email about this. I had missed it, about activism in Animal Crossing.
I know. This is like something from PETA when they were mad about Animal Crossing.
Yeah. So Animal Crossing has become quite the battleground, I guess, for activists. Now, Animal Crossing.
Okay, Animal Crossing. But let's take a moment. How are they? You can be an activist on your island, but unless you're doing videos of them or you're leaving your island open to anyone who wants to come in, how are people seeing it?
Because
people can just choose not to go to your island or not put the dream code. So you're just preaching to the choir, and it's not actually accomplishing anything.
Stop making sense. We're gonna talk about that. We'll talk about some other stuff in relation to it before we get into it. Reminder, we do have an enamel pin up for pre-order at shopclownfish.com. When they're gone, they're gone, so they're super limited. If you want to help the channel, grab a pin with Bubbly Steve. All right, so before we get into the Animal Crossing bit, I found this last year. This was actually talking about how at the Social Innovation Summit 2019, this was a summer summit last year, they talked about how...
CIS 2019.
They were talking about how today's organizations are shifting toward greater social impact and entertainment and culture being linked, and how activism can use entertainment, that it builds empathy, focuses on the storytellers, etc., etc. So they had a whole thing, I guess, at this summit to push entertainment industries or individual influencers to use their platforms for the greater good.
But who decides what's the greater good?
Twitter.
Okay.
Twitter decides the greater good.
They put the twit in Twitter.
Putting the twit in Twitter. So that leads us to... Okay, you can feel any way you want to feel.
You can use your island any way you want to use your island.
Any way you want to use it. But there is a push into gaming for more political content, and sometimes it's backfiring tremendously. I feel the same way about this as I do with, like, blatant evangelism in entertainment.
Well, I was going to say, because it works so well for comics and the movie industry, TV shows.
Right. So, now, these are individuals. I want to clarify. These are individuals who feel... strongly that their Animal Crossing island
is their islands. They can do what they want.
They can do whatever they want.
More power to them. If that's what they want to advocate for on their island, then, you know, go them.
Right. So that is how they want to use it. But the article also seems to imply that game developers need to be more proactive in their activism.
Because that's what I thought when I started playing Animal Crossing. I was walking around the island and I was like, oh my God, how can I take this and change it and use it for activism?
Yeah, right.
I spend every day. No entertainment. You're not allowed to have entertainment. Fun? No.
That's the problem a lot of people are having. They're like, okay, look, we get that there are some social causes out there. We get that there's a lot of shit going on in the real world. But can't we just have our video games without having to hear about it? Can't
for
we just
the Oasis.
For the Oasis, yeah. So they tried doing this with Fortnite. They had a panel on Fortnite on race, and they put a tomato vending machine next to the screen. And of course, you know what happened. Everybody started throwing tomatoes at the speakers because
wait, like virtual tomatoes?
Yes, virtual tomatoes.
Wait, wait, why would they put a tomato vending machine there?
That's a damn good question.
So I think they want people to throw tomatoes.
Yes, apparently.
I don't. That doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't make sense.
My brain hurts. What?
So here's what happened. Okay. Here's what happened. They talked about the special experiences of Fortnite not happening in the normal combat mode. Instead, players are dumped into a special non-competitive game mode where their interactions are different. In this case, the movie theater for Fortnite often involves being near a vending machine that can drop various items, including gliders, vehicles, and yes, tomatoes. The game also includes an emote where players can toss tomatoes.
Okay, so they chose to do it.
Yeah, did tomato slinging happen at every screening? No. Should Epic Games have rethought the area where people watch and consider what players might do?
Okay,
probably.
Now I understand. So it wasn't like they did it up. They weren't thinking ahead on this. Okay, now
right.
It makes sense. Okay, I was like, why would you do that on purpose? I'm like, what are you just asking for trouble?
So they had a BLM summit in Fortnite, which, okay. And they dropped a tomato vending machine next to the screen, and
are they doing it on purpose so they can yell about racism?
I don't know. It did.
Because I mean, I'm not trying to be a jerk, but like every time you see this stuff, which we're going to talk about one thing here in a minute, and if someone doesn't agree with you, even if it has nothing to do with anything other than like, you know, a different kind of reason, it's obviously because you're sexist, racist, whatever.
Social experiment.
It's if, like, really?
If we preach to people in their video game, and we put a tomato vending machine.
How much will they hate us?
Next.
That's
if they,
a tomato meter.
If they throw tomatoes, that's how we know which ones are the racist.
That's right.
And we kick them out of the game. No, right. they didn't do that. But I'm just saying, like,
they have a Rotten Tomatoes crossover, the tomato meter.
Right, right. There we go. They could do that. So, yeah, it didn't work very well. Because, look, a lot of people, regardless of how you feel about the situation, a lot of people turn to video games and entertainment to escape everything going on in the real world right now.
The real world right now is kind of not that great. Let's be honest. I mean, between 2020 has been a lot of bad. And we had, you know, between the virus and between, like, you know, Australia had been on fire. And then we had, like, the thing in Beirut. And then we had, you know, the protests / riots, depending on who you ask. And, you know, this election year, so there's all kinds of crap going on there. And all this other stuff, and schools are closed down, and you can't travel, and people are trapped in their houses, and then they just drive people extra crazy, and all that other stuff. It's just not been a good year. The last thing you want is to turn on entertainment and then have more of it shoved in your face. You want to be able to get away from it.
Yeah, so I think, you know, what we're seeing now is a pushback, and I have to wonder, under normal circumstances, would there be such a push for activism in entertainment at every
clearly,
turn?
Because that was from last year.
Well, yeah, but
it's been for a couple years. But this year, I think people are just going overboard. What else are they going to do?
Well, that's it. People are stuck in their houses. So people that would maybe not be as obnoxious on Twitter have gone full on twit this year because they've been stuck in their house for months and they have nothing to think about.
It was bad before, but now when you've got nothing to do but sit on there and stew
and play Animal Crossing, so it all bleeds over. I mean, it's literally the people on Twitter are like, they wake up angry, they go to bed angry, they go play Animal Crossing, they're not getting away from it, they're
okay.
Still angry.
This year you could argue it's not necessarily their fault because, you know, things are going on that are outside their control, but
right.
A lot of times these people go to it's not a new thing. When people go to bed angry, they wake up angry, and they're always angry, and they're always angry, and they're always angry at somebody and something, and they're looking for something to be more angry about. But then at the end of the day, whose choice is it to keep being angry?
Yeah, look, you can do with your island whatever.
It's coming for me, people.
Yeah,
so
right?
I'm like, you know.
I'm always angry. So they're talking about the in-game protests that they have on Animal Crossing and The Sims. They're in contrast with the gaming industry's relatively subdued response to BLM. I don't know. This seems like it's not, you know. Then I know some folks were shutting down servers. I think Rockstar Games shut their servers down. They had a moment of black screen or something for like an hour. I forget exactly.
That's
what
more
happened.
Than a moment.
Well, it was, yeah. But while a handful of companies pledged donations, displays of solidarity largely consisted of vague social media posts, a few delayed events and releases, and in-game gestures that get tomatoes. Developers at Epic Games removed police cars from Fortnite, prompting some Twitter users to mock congratulate them on successfully ending racism.
Sorry, that's funny.
Abonix says the $1 million donation from The Sims developer EA was a step in the right direction, but hopes it isn't just a one-off. Ensuring that racial injustice is challenged.
Keep giving us money.
It needs to become an integral part of the company. So they're talking about how game developers aren't doing enough. There just isn't enough activism in games. They're talking about Hong Kong and all the issues in Hong Kong and the difference between how they handled it in Overwatch, I guess, versus Hong Kong. But here we go. This is a 30-year-old from Hong Kong living in London, created the free Hong Kong t-shirts for protesters to wear in Animal Crossing the day Hong Kong's wide-ranging national security law came into effect. In-game action has always offered a safer alternative, who used to run into tear gas daily. I guess it's a little easier to have a protest on an Animal Crossing island than to actually...
Yeah,
it's
true.
actual protest.
You know, in this person's case, physically, they probably don't want to have to deal with that. So
yeah, so they're wearing it. And again, that's fine. You can do whatever you want to do.
If you're on your game, if you want to wear these shirts, if you want to do whatever, you can. That's up to you. But the line gets drawn when you're expecting everybody else to do the same.
So earlier this month, a World of Warcraft player was penalized for asking other players to say trans rights as a way of screening gamers who wanted to join them on raids.
What? So,
as a way of screen.
I know, I get that, but I'm like, were they that good that everybody was lining up and you had to say that to play with them? I mean,
I don't know, but they were contacted by the customer service department and they were told to avoid discussing politics in the communication channel.
Well, they always say don't politics and religion are two things you shouldn't talk about. Sadly, they seem like the same thing now.
Right, so they talked about the game having hypocrisy, noting they were told this on the same day Blizzard delivered a live stream in support of BLM.
Just because you support something doesn't mean that you're making everybody that uses your platform, you know, give your vocal statements to play. There's a difference here.
Right, so this is interesting. I didn't know this. So wait, Animal Crossing has been banned in China because of this. Hold on a second. Because Blizzard, they had a BLM message, but they penalized people who were talking about Hong Kong because, you know, Blizzard, of course, you know, owned by a Chinese company.
Right,
so they're real happy about
it. Yes, I remember that.
Not real happy about it. So Blizzard was subsequently forced to apologize and reduce the player's ban. It was over Hearthstone. Many accused Blizzard of trying to appease the Chinese government.
Yeah, that's been going on for a while.
For fear the game might be pulled from the market there. This was, after all, what happened to Animal Crossing, which was banned from China after in-game Hong Kong protests, proof that players' political activism can carry severe consequences for development. So
you know what else is banned there? Winnie the Pooh. So it's a low bar.
Can you get Winnie the Pooh to move to your island? So it's funny, if you say you want to keep politics out of games, the response is BLM isn't politics, it's human rights. But that's still politics.
Human rights are human rights. I just love how some human rights matter and other human rights don't.
Animal Crossing and other platforms, like, it serves as a form of escapism. This is the thing. We're going to talk about that. You can't get away from it. And this is what got me. Human beings suffering from systemic racism and violence don't get the privilege of escaping from this reality, and neither should anyone else.
Really? Because, you know, they, as people, are racist towards everyone else. I'm sorry. Racism is a problem, and I've honestly never seen it as bad as it's been right now. It's a problem, and I'm sorry, it's not just white people that are racist.
It's the world's gone crazy, and I don't think it would be as, in your face if it wasn't for people being in lockdown for so long. But everything is about race now. Twitter, especially. You can't say anything on Twitter.
Like this, okay? So they're doing these series for The Flash coming next year. Apparently they did one for Iris, which no one's even mentioned the fact that they show her in the other pictures as, you know... So they're doing one for Iris, and everybody's mad because it's Iris and not The Flash. But my understanding is they're going to be doing more posters. Like, this is the first one of several, I'm thinking. Mm. But people, of course, were asking, why are we doing a poster of her when the show is called The Flash? Why isn't it about The Flash? Why are we on, you know, her character? And, of course, don't you know, if you don't like her Iris West, you are hating the actress, you don't like the actress, and you're just racist and sexist, and you should just move on.
should just move on.
Because clearly, if you are questioning anything related to why it isn't the main character on a damn poster, it's because you're some kind of problematic person. You have to understand that you're an istinophobe. People are just like, but I don't like Iris West's character. It has nothing to do with the actress. And the fact is, why is she on the poster for the show that's called The Flash? And, you know, people are just, yeah, Sport Coat Girl, yeah.
Sport Coat Girl is my favorite comic book character. Mm-hmm.
So people are like, what the heck? And I understand she's been more important to the show. I haven't watched it, honestly, for a long time. I got bored with it. And apparently she's more important to the story now. But another redhead that, you know, has been, you know, race bet, by the way. But everybody's like, you know, if you don't like her character, there's something wrong with you. Maybe her character's boring.
God.
A lot of people are like, I like the actress. I don't like the character.
Yeah, and that's what happened with Rose Tico, too. It was like Rose Tico was kind of pointless and her character was kind of lame. And that turned into, you just hate Kelly Marie Tran. And that turned into, you're just a racist.
Well, that's how this turned out. People question things. They're like, I don't understand why you're showing Iris on the Flash's poster as the main character. And instead of the answer being like, oh, they're going to release more posters, just one for different characters, so like that people would accept. You're just racist, sexist, misogynist. How dare you?
Because that helps your point.
If you ask a question, that obviously means that that's what you are.
Yeah, I had an interesting comment yesterday. I was talking about race in Dungeons and Dragons and how it was kind of dumb to change it, because when we're talking about races, we're talking about non-humans. We're not talking about persons, you know, humans' ethnicity. Humans are viewed as one race in D&D. Had somebody come into the comments and was like, you being upset about this, you know, I tried to give you the benefit of the doubt.
No, you didn't.
But I watched the video, and this is right up there with defending the Confederate flag. I was like,
yeah, that's what that I can see that connection.
What? I was like, what the hell are
that
you talking
matter,
about?
That doesn't matter, because they're psychotic. And they go, at halftime, I love it, they come in there and start yelling about a video, and you shouldn't say this because this, and it's like, but did you watch the video? Because we said that because of this, and this. No, they didn't watch the video. They're just in there yelling and screaming. And it's like, you know,
nobody's listening. After a while, people just hit the mute button on you, and they don't listen.
No, and the thing is, they're on there yelling about, okay, I'm trying to figure how, you know, saying that you can't have different classes and calling them races in the game that's been that way for years makes the same thing as the Confederate flag.
I have no idea. But this is the thing. This is the problem with armchair activism, just in general.
I think it's a problem with stupidity.
It's noise, right? And when you make so much noise, people just hit the mute button completely. They're not.
That's exactly what's happening.
Yeah, they're not listening to anything you're saying, because you're saying so much stupid stuff in addition to what your point is, that your point's being missed. If you chose your words more carefully and picked your battles more carefully, and you know, said fewer things, but they were more impactful, you actually would probably affect
change.
And
if you seem more reasonable, like this is an example I keep using. If someone's in the corner and they want to talk to you about something, they're willing to actually discuss something, listen, and have back and forth to discuss something, and maybe you both will gain something from it. That's one thing, as opposed to the person on the corner yelling, patriarchy, misogyny, patriarchy. Who's going to get further?
Yeah.
Because the one person everybody's just going to turn around and walk away from, there's going to be no discussion. They're not going to listen to anybody who has anything really to say about this in the future, because all they're going to think of is that one person. So all you're doing is you are just driving everyone to not listen to you. Congratulations.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, it just becomes a bunch of noise, you know? And so I don't think, you can do whatever you want to do, but demanding that companies, that game developers, that TV shows, whatever, participate in activism isn't actually activism. Because a lot of times, you know, even if they're not feeling it, it's just lip service.
Yeah, anyway. They're just doing it because it shut you up.
They're doing it so you don't mob them. Look what happened to Gina Carano. She wouldn't put out blatantly political messaging, and she got mobbed on Twitter for it, and they were going to force her to say something, and she's like, hell no.
They were going to try to. They can't force someone. They're just whatever. Wham, wham, go change your Pampers.
Yeah, she could bench press all of you. She could power or pile drive any of these people. But, you know, it's interesting because they're trying to force celebrities into that role, too. And sometimes they don't want to be in that role. Zendaya, that's not Zendaya, by the way, that's an ad, but Zendaya said that, you know, she refuses to call herself an activist. I'm just an actress. Like, I think she gets it. She gets that, like...
No one wants that position. I mean, she might advocate for things.
Right, right.
That matter to her, but she doesn't want to be to have that weight on her to be like, well, you have to go out and be, you know, the voice for us. It's not her job to be the voice for you, just because she has a platform. No one owes you their platform. To be, you know, the speaking part for that.
Yeah. And that's it. And that's what I think is going on here is we have activists who want to, you know, take the platform. They're gaming, you know, obviously, you know, tabletop gaming, video gaming, animation, comics, television. And their attitude is basically you owe it to people for the greater good. To give up your platform for activism.
Yeah, and if you don't, then they're going to try to do everything they can to put you under.
Yeah.
Which is I'm sorry. That's just sad. That's just so childish, petty. And I would expect, I guess I shouldn't expect anything better from the participation trophy, you know, generation.
So, yeah, I mean, look, the wheels were kind of turning years ago, and we're seeing that now. And it's going to get, I think there's going to be more overt politics. Just this is the way it is right now. I think, you know, at least for the foreseeable future.
At least the election.
Yeah, at least the election.
And then they'll start for next one.
But then if people tune out, they'll accuse them of being racist too. If you're just tired of it, even if you agree and you're just tired of being hit upside the head with bad news all day long, it'll be like, well, you're just a racist and you don't want
to
hear it.
Oh, yeah, I know. That's what happens to people like us all the time. It's like, you know, I'm not disagreeing with every one of your points, but I don't agree with 100% of your points. Well, how dare you? No, how dare you? I don't really care, but whatever.
Yeah, morning, noon, and night. That's not what we obsess about. So I'm sorry.
You know what? When you start talking and screaming, we just like, oh, I don't have to watch this. Click.
That's what.
Oh, I don't have to. I don't have to read this post. Scroll.
Yes, and that's exactly what, you know, is going to happen. Is the more overt the politics are, the more people are going to tune out. The more they're going to stop buying product. The more, and you're not reaching anybody at that point. Because it's all just noise.
I think the majority of people, like they said, that as percentage-wise, very few people are extremist enough to be these people. And they said most people are just are like in the middle and they don't care.
Yeah.
I mean, they care, but they're just like tired of hearing about it. Even if they care, even if someone totally cares, if you annoy them enough, they're not going to care anymore.
That is true. So we're going to wrap this one up.
Yep.
Okay, so please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants. And we'll talk to you guys later.
Bye.
Hey guys, thanks for watching Clownfish TV. Please consider supporting the channel. Go to clownfishsupport.com. That's clownfishsupport.com. And if you want to join our community, go to clownfishtalk.com. That's clownfishtalk.com. Please subscribe, ring the bell for notifications. We will talk to you next time.